In this figure, we want to talk a little bit about retinal processing of light information. And we're going to talk about what are called center surround receptive fields. And we're going to focus on the rods, because the rods are the only photoreceptive cells that undergo dramatic convergence, in that they synapse with a very much smaller number of bipolar cells, and then actually can that convergence can continue a large number of bipolar cells synapsing on an even smaller number of ganglion cells, not shown here. Now, because we have this large array of rods that synapse and send their information to, in this case, a single bipolar cell, what we find is that not all these rods send information equally to that bipolar cell. In other words, we end up with a center surround arrangement within this receptive field, right? This would be the receptive field. This entire span of rods would all send their information through this one bipolar cell. Now, because of this arrangement where centrally located rods synapse directly with the bipolar cell, whereas the rods in the periphery here do not. They actually synapse indirectly through these horizontal cells with the bipolar cells. And what that allows, what that provides, is the potential for a difference between how the center cells activate the bipolar cell and how the peripheral cells would activate the bipolar cell. And you end up with bipolar cells that are divided up into two groups, on-center bipolar cells and off-center bipolar cells. And what that essentially means is that when light, going over here to the left, when light comes in and hits the center of an on-center bipolar receptive field, it's an on-cell, which meaning the light hitting the center would actually stimulate this bipolar cell, and light hitting the surround would inhibit it. Conversely, there are off-center bipolar cells, in which case light hitting the center would turn it off, and light hitting the surround would activate it. And you might ask, why all the complexity? Well, first of all, the degree of convergence is important because it dramatically reduces the amount of processing required of the central nervous system. It does create a situation where rods provide low definition vision, but it saves us an enormous amount of visual processing because it's not every rod is not wired through its own bipolar cell to its own ganglion cell. Now, why the on-off center situation? That actually helps enhance contrast, right? Because when light hits the center, what we want is it to be distinguished most dramatically from the regions around it, right? And so essentially by activating for an on-center cell, activating the center, and then inhibiting the periphery, what we get is an enhancement of contrast between light hitting those two areas. Again, contrast being one of the most important qualities of retinal processing.